On Friday the 31st of March, the Place subreddit was born over on the website Reddit. It started as a huge empty canvas where any user could choose to change one of the pixels every 5 minutes. I saw it pretty early on, when it was just a load of random dots with a few small pictures strewn about. My first thought was, well, this is going to end in disaster. I added my dot and left it alone. But I was proven wrong. I couldn't have imagined what the combined collaborations between individuals achieved over the following weekend. Subreddits began to fight for places on this huge canvas, and before long it became a bubbling and exciting ecosystem of pixel art. Logos, icons, flags and text popped up and then would have to fight for survival against everything else around it, as well as hundreds of vandalism attempts from passers-by. I personally just corrected vandalism attempts on my favourite icons. As an individual, I don't think there's much else you could do. Not unless you work for a specific subreddit to help defend their place on the picture, or choose to spend your clicks deliberately ruining whatever anybody else tried to make. I found it interesting that you could see whoever submitted the current pixel, almost an effort to shame those who were out to spoil it, and an attractive offer for anybody looking to leave their mark on the artwork that was forming. Of course, vandalism existed. An evil void force popped up in the middle, trying to consume everything, returning it to nothing. This sort of thing really annoyed me, bringing back traumatic memories of my sandcastles getting smashed by bullies when I was younger. Others got frustrated by it too. Topics popped up everywhere complaining that spam bots were ruining it and that there was no way that real users could challenge the threat. Vandals became clever. Instead of deliberately ruining bits, they'd instead start extending the borders of those around it, creating wars between subreddits. I decided that Place's ruin was inevitable and left it to its own devices, dismissing it as a curiosity rather than an actual thing that could survive. And yet, it continued to prosper. More logos were added, vandalism was kept under control, and stories popped up in every bit of the canvas. It seemed that the vast majority of contributors were proud of this project. Soon the lines between creativity and vandalism were blurred, and some amusing stories were written. I loved the way that Germany invaded France, only for France to escape and to eventually call a truce in the form of the European Union. The He-Man dude frothed at the mouth. Blunts were smoked. AMD changed colour several times, its supporters seemingly confused about the colour it should have been. CSGO kept getting a penis, and its gun would poke into the next logo along. The American flag came under heavy attack, yet it ultimately prevailed. Visit any part of Reddit and people would be talking about their bit of Place and what was going on. It was even coded into Minecraft, in real time, with every update building on a square so that you could see which were the most contested positions in the whole of Place. And then, today, it ended. The final canvas, immortalised forever. It isn't perfect. Those small stray dots are definitely infuriating to all those who took part. And yet, it remains something to be proud of. A work of art, indeed containing several more within. Place is perhaps one of the most interesting social experiments ever created, and a testament to the viewership of Reddit that, combined, we're able to become something more than just a haze of spam. It's restored my faith in humanity a tiny bit and has opened my eyes to what the internet can achieve when working together in such large numbers and in such a short amount of time.